Welcome back to iSpring Video Tutorials. Today I'm going to show you how to edit the audio in your courses.
In the previous tutorial, how to create course narration, I recorded some audio.
I'm going to use this to show you the ropes. I'm going to begin by importing the audio into this new project by heading to Manage Narration in the toolbar, then selecting Audio. iSpring supports all the most popular audio formats, including MP3, WAV, and WMA. From here, I can import as many files as I like by selecting them, and then by hitting Open. Now you have the option to import slides starting from your cursor position or from the beginning of any slide you select. You can also select this Adjust Slide button if you want to automatically adjust the duration of each slide to match your audio clip length. I'm going to adjust my slide length manually later. Now that all my files have been opened in the timeline, I'm ready to edit. But first, I'm going to quickly zoom out of my view of the timeline by adjusting this slider. There, now I can see my whole project. I want to begin by editing this first clip. To do this, I will right-click and then select Edit Clip. This will bring up the audio editor for this clip. The first thing I'm going to do is add the Remove Noise filter. I love that iSpring has this option so that I can filter out some of the ambient and background noise and make my recording sound more professional. Next, I'm going to trim up the intro and outro to get rid of any unwanted ends. To do this, I simply highlight the area on the time that I want to keep, then select the trim button from the menu bar and the extra space before and after the voiceover disappears. Next, I want to adjust the volume of my clip. There are two ways I can do this. The first way is by adjusting the volume of the whole clip by selecting the Adjust Volume button and then adjusting the slider. See how the waveforms grow and shrink when I slide the bar? I can give it a listen at any time to make sure it sounds okay. I'm happy with this, so I will select OK to apply the settings. The second way to adjust the volume, and a more precise way, is to select just a portion of the audio I want to edit, and then select Adjust Volume from the toolbar. Now you will see that when I slide the bar, it only affects the highlighted area. Sounds good. Let's move on. As you can see, in the menu bar, you also have the option to fade your audio in and out. Those options are best for music, so I won't be applying them for my voiceover. Okay, that's all I want to do to this audio clip, so I will save and close the audio editor and head back to Manage Narration. From this view, I can adjust where my audio actually sits in the timeline. I will use the zoom bar to get right in close to look at this. Now that I have a close-up view of my first slide and audio, I will adjust the audio by selecting and dragging it. I'm going to move this audio clip over so there is a bit of a pause before it starts. There. Now I can see that my slide is a little too long, so I will adjust it as well by simply dragging the end to make it shorter. Perfect! Let's watch it to see if I have the right timing.
Welcome to this employee fast motor sales training.
Yep, that is just right. Now that I'm happy with the adjustments I have made, I'm going to go ahead and save and close to head back to PowerPoint. And there we have it! Now you know just how easy it can be to edit your voiceover narration with iSpring Suite.